To my right, the water coming at us is estimated at 35 to 40 kilometers an hour. The estimated flow of the Niagara River is approximately 170 million liters per minute. Still to my right on the American side, you'll notice a long gray fence on the top of the cliff. This is the Whirlpool State Park in Niagara Falls, New York. Looking downstream, you'll notice a long concrete wall. This is the Robert Moses Generating Station in Houston, New York. Those of you looking at the Whirlpool, you will notice it is going in a counterclockwise direction. This is because at this time of day, the water is at full capacity. At night, between the hours of midnight and 8 a.m., the water is diverted to power plants, lowering it by about 20 feet. Once it is lowered, it will change directions to clockwise. This attraction has been in operation since 1916 and was built and designed by a Spanish engineer named Niagara Torres. Up until 2003, the Whirlpool Aero Car was named a Spanish Aero Car.
I took pictures of the sign over there. I thought it was cool.
Now that we are nearing the far end, we are going to be rotating. We're going to do this by walking in a big circle. For those of you that are on my right, you are walking towards me. Those of you on my left, you are walking away from me. Please start walking now.
Start walking across. Sir? Sir? Walk across. Walk across. Across.
Just have a light show.
You want me help?
Please stay as close as possible to the person in front of you as you do not have much walking room. The car is going to stop. It will hold for 5 seconds and it will continue going whether we are stations or not.
They told me this
is part of our journey where the people have dropped their phones, so I suggest you put them away.
Keep going. Keep going.
Keep going.
Closer
we get, the faster we go.
Feel on first speed, jump over the yellow.
Are suspended between 6 interlocking steel cables, 1 inch in diameter each. We are powered by an electric 50 horsepower motor and have been traveling at a whopping speed of 8 kilometers an hour. In the event of a power failure, we do have a diesel motor that will pull us back to the dock. If that does not work, there is a rescue car located in the cave behind us. The rescue car holds 4 passengers and 1 operator, so luckily we have never had to use it.
Want to.
between two Canadian points, we do cross the American border a total of 4 times. With that being said, I'd like to welcome you to the state of New York.
Freaking crazy.